दोस्तों ग्लोबल इकोनॉमिक समिट से मेरे साथ में आज हैं मिस्टर अमित पाल। अमित पाल जी एक पैन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनी है, उसके डायरेक्टर हैं। तो आइए हम उनसे बात करते हैं कि उनकी जो कंपनी है इसके बारे में और इसमें जो इन्होंने भाग लिया है क्या इनका अगर होगा। अमित जी वेलकम टू अवर चैनल इंडिया।
थैंक यू वेरी मच एंड आई ऑल्सो थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी अपॉर्चुनिटी टू एक्सप्रेस माई व्यू अबाउट माई पेन एज वेल एज वॉट आई हैव लर्न्ड फ्रॉम द दिस जीएस।
यस यस
थैंक यू फॉर दैट।
किस तरह का रेस्पॉन्स रहा इस बार सेविंग जीएस में?
आई वुड बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट विथ यू, दिस इज फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैव बीन अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस वन एंड आई कैन टेल यू वन थिंग, आई एम प्रीटी मच excited. Mm-hmm. I've been able to meet 20 new people, mm-hmm. out of which I personally feel that my export could grow at least 3 times, mm-hmm. and because 10 of them are very much potential. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about in terms of buyers. Mm-hmm. It is basically a very good networking platform for the small and medium.
कहाँ से buyers आपको approach किए, मतलब कितने buyers आपको मिल गए या मिल वाले वाले?
मैं आपको बताता हूँ और जो जो कंट्री की बात मैं कर रहा हूँ, some of them are basically from North Africa, mm-hmm. that is Morocco, mm-hmm. and Algeria. Mm-hmm. One of them is from Europe, mm-hmm. is France, mm-hmm. and we also may have met one USA portal company, mm-hmm. who has got an export portal, mm-hmm. and they promote the multi product of almost all the manufacturer exporters through their platform. Mm-hmm. So I met few of them, and of course there's one small country I must say, mm-hmm. they buy a lot of pens because the location is very high there, mm-hmm. is Cambodia.
Cambodia.
So okay. I'm happy with, you know, these people. In addition to that, I have met some potential importers, mm-hmm. or some export houses, okay. of India who okay, would like to buy my pen and sell it off.
When your company was started and what is the current status of the company?
I had basically thought of having a pen company in the year 2009, mm-hmm. and it started actually in 2011. Full commissioning of the production of the ball pen started in 2011, mm-hmm. and I have exactly completed 7 years. Now this is the 8th year that I have basically got into, mm-hmm. and I am exporting near about in 19 countries, mm-hmm. in the world. 19 countries.
Already your presence in 19 countries?
Yes, and but most of them very honestly are in Southeast Asia and East Africa and North Africa. And now I'm trying to explore my, you know, I would like to explore USA and European market where I had never been, you know, able to sell a single container.
Maybe know that ki what is the total volume of business of pen industry in India and how many major players in the field?
There are major players mainly from Mumbai.
Nationwide, countrywide. Sello may be leader in Mumbai. Your pen company, Kolor, may be leading in Kolkata.
Okay, fine. Then I will give you one clarification. Yes, I have got your point. I am 100% exporter of ball pen. I do not promote my pen in India. Whatever I produce, it all goes abroad.
Okay.
And I take the full benefit and support of the government of India. I must tell you, the government has many subsidy schemes. Uh-huh. Through the Plastics Export Promotion Council, Ministry of Commerce, they fund us for market development assistance in abroad. We always get subsidized airfare and subsidized rent for the exhibition stall, while we basically rent a stall in abroad. It is how we promote our product in abroad. So government of India has a bigger role to play, and they are playing that role till now. The subsidy is not yet withdrawn. And I think it's a very big thing for people like us who belong to SME sector. And this particular summit was on MSME growth.
Yes, yes, yes.
So this is why it is very important. Mm-hmm. As we can see, and of course, and one more thing I would like to add before I finish that, mm-hmm. in any business, if you really want to succeed, you should have a combination of 3 E, alphabet E.
Yeah.
E for economy, mm-hmm. E for excellence, mm-hmm. E for ethics.
Okay.
If you do not have these 3 E's present in your business, it's very difficult to be a successful businessman.
Okay, but I would like to know one thing that, okay, why are you not serving in India? Is there any technical reason?
No, it's not technical reason. Let me tell you one thing, my friend. India is a very big country. If you really want to promote your product in every nook and corner of India, you have to spend a lot of money through electronic media. so that yes, the Indians buy such a product, because we are always guided by the electronic media.
Yes.
Right? And you need to pump in a lot of money. In hindsight, I feel, instead of spending that amount of money to promote my product in India, almost spending one-tenth of that, if I could promote my product in abroad, why not in abroad?
In fact, this is one reason. And subsidy maybe also?
Subsidy is available to everybody. But we get subsidy for promoting our product, that is called MDA. I must tell you, my friend, that the government of India has got this market development assistance for the companies below 30 crore turnover. You can take the benefit as long as your turnover is below 30 crores. You get this assistance for promoting your product, wherever the government of India is having
exhibition. And your company, current status is what, financial status?
I would rather say we have applied for the 3-star export house status from the DGFT, Director General of Foreign Trade. And I am the 4th largest exporter of ball pen from Eastern India.
In crores, I want to know, how many crores?
It's almost now 12 crores.
12 crores?
In a year.
In a year.
Yeah. And single-handedly, because you have to understand, I am the first generation businessman of my family, and only I have just begun 7 years ago.
Okay. And you have and manufacturing unit in India?
In Kolkata, that is exactly 40 kilometers away in a place called Fatehpur. Because as we know, pen is being generally made by plastics. Plastics is basically a hazardous item as far as environment is concerned. So we have our unit little bit away from the city.
Okay, how many manpower is there?
See, we have near about 30 people who are basically permanent and 47 people who are basically casual.
Okay.
Total 77 to 80 people. But yes, if you talk in terms of the family, we are near about giving, I would say...
You have invested your own money in the company?
Yes, I have invested my own money.
Or have you borrowed the loan from
very
banks?
Honestly, I would say, whatever I'm doing it single-handedly without taking one paisa loan from any bank whatsoever.
Why are you not taking loan from any bank?
Because my company, I understand that, but my company is progressing without taking any loan, and somehow or the other, I personally feel, it's my philosophy, if I could manage my company without taking any loan, why should I basically unnecessarily have one more liability which can act as basically a pressure?
But people are taking loan in 1,000 crore, 500 crore, why? Where they have put the money?
Well, in that case, if you talk in the present context of that particular diamond margin, I would rather basically stop short by saying that, again, it comes back to the ethics, because the gentleman you are talking about has lost his entire reputation of his life in one single day because of the media, and he doesn't have a locus standi anymore.
Yes, yes.
Whereas I may be a small company, I may be not a MSME sector,
but
I can tell you one thing, I do not need to basically fear anything about my goodwill. You create your own goodwill, and this is something only you can destroy.
Nobody
else will make goodwill for you. You do it for yourself, and you destroy it for yourself.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Ameet.
Thank you.
आपने समय निकाला
इसके लिए धन्यवाद.
दोस्तों, कैसा लगा इंटरव्यू हमारा? आप हमारे YouTube चैनल इंडिया आज तक पर जाइए, शेयर, सब्सक्राइब, लाइक एंड कमेंट. थैंक यू.